दाडीम दाल्यते विदार्यते रसवाप्तर्थमिति. नेक्स्ट द बॉटनिकल नेम ऑफ दाडीम दैट इज पुनिका ग्रेनाटम. पुनिका ग्रेनाटम इज द बॉटनिकल सोर्स. व्हाट इट मीन्स पुनिका, पुनिका दैट इज स्पेसिफिकली पर्टेनिंग टू द पेरिकॉर्प दैट इज इट इज केदर दैट इज अ कार्सिनोजेनिक एप्पल दे यूज्ड टू सेज लाइक कार्थेज. The outer layer or the outer layer of the fruit, that is the which denotes about the punica. And the granatum, granatum means it is filled with the seed. That fruit is filled with the seed. That is the meaning of granatum, punica granatum. Okay, so as it is belongs to the family Punicaceae family, so the botanist, they have included it under Lytheraceae family. But still in the examination you can write as it is the text they used to mention under Punicaceae family. But the recent text, the journals, they used to mention it under Lytheraceae family. Okay, so Punicaceae is old name. In the examinations you can write as a Punicaceae. If you in bracket if you want you can write the Lytheraceae, the recent name, the recent family which is included under Lytheraceae family. Okay, so Punica granatum, it is belongs to the family Punicaceae family. The vernacular names, as you all know, in Hindi it is called anar, in English it is called pomegranate, kannadadalli dalimbe hannu. Okay, so next we'll move to the ganas. According to charaka, charaka it is mentioned under hrudya mahakashaya, chardi nigrahana mahakashaya and shramahara mahakashaya. Hrudya, chardi nigrahana, shramahara mahakashaya. So the first 10 mahakashaya, that is the last among the first 10 mahakashaya, that is the rudhya mahakashaya. As you all know, the rudhya mahakashaya dravyas are mainly having amla rasa predominant. They are having the predominance of amla rasa. So what is meant by rudhya? So rudayaya hitam rudhyam, the drugs one which are beneficial, the drugs one which are useful in treating or in treating the related to the cardiac disorders. Hrudayaya hitam hrudyam. So usually if you see the definition of especially the raktakshaya lakshana amle shishira preetihi, amle shishira preetihi, when the person is having raktakshaya, so at that time the person is having more interest towards the amla rasatmaka dravyas, more interest towards the amla rasatmaka dravyas. As the dadima is also one of the amla rasatmaka dravya, so when you take the amdrasatmaka dravyas, that is like the adima drugs, even in the international the journals they have there are so many research activities they have mentioned, like the cardiotonic activity of dadima. There it shows it cures many the cardiac related diseases, especially cardiovascular the disorders where there will be the blockages. So many the conditions you can treat by using dadima. So dadima in the form of as a aushadha, as well as also it is a preventive aspect, you can take as a ahara dravya also, as a ahara dravya which gives strength to the cardiac muscles, and also which is going to enhances the blood, and also it can cure many the disorders related to the cardiac. Okay, hrudya mahakashaya. So among them, so what are the drugs which are mentioned under hrudya mahakashaya? That is all the drugs you can easily remember: ambra, ambrataka, lakucha, karamardha, rukshamla, amla vetasa, dadima, badhara, matulunga iti dashamani hrudyani bhavanti. Okay, ambra, ambrataka, lakucha, karamardha, rukshamla, amla vetasa, kuvala, badhara, dadima, matulunga iti dashamani hrudyani bhavanti. So if you see all the drugs, so any one drug which is not divide of any the amla rasas. Okay, so all the drugs are having amla rasatmaka dravyas. See, ambra ambrataka, that is mangifera indica, ambra ambrataka, lakucha, that is Artocarpus lakucha, and karamardha, that is kavalika in Kannada we used to say, that is also one of the amla rasatmaka dravya. Rukshamla, that is as you all know the garcinia indica, rukshamla, amla vetasa, amla vetasa, kuvala, that is a type of badara. Okay, kuvala, that is a type of badara, and dadima, so matulunga, all the drugs. So most of the drugs are like citrus family drugs are also mentioned. So all the drugs are having amlarasa. So definitely these drugs which will enhances the potency which will enhances the or which will cure or overcome the conditions related to the heart, hrudaya. Okay, hrudya mahakashaya dravyas. So next he mentioned about chardi nigrahana mahakashaya. That is chardi nigrahana, trushna nigrahana, hika nigrahana. That is the second 10. So second 10 drugs. That is nigrahana. Chardim nigrahanati stambhayati chardi nigrahanam. Chardim nigrahanati stambhayati. So as you all know the chardi, that is naturally, that you can say like emetic, emesis. Not like the vamana. Vamana we are going to induce. Whereas chardi, which is that is occur, naturally occur. Depending upon the various causative factors, the chardi they used to occur. Okay. So here, chardi nigrahana. So like you can compare with anti-emetics. The drugs one which does the nigrahana of the chardi. So what may be the causative factors? But if you use these drugs, for example, if you take like the traveling sickness, when the person he used to travel, especially like the hilly areas. So most of the persons they used to have the vomiting sensation. Vomiting sensation, or sometimes the person may vomit. So if you take like if you hold or if you take the odor of nimbuka, so when you take the odor of nimbuka, so immediately which will suppress the vomiting center, that is chardi, which will suppress the vomiting center and will reduce the or will overcome the condition called the chardi. Okay, so they used to suppress. So in this, like the especially in case of pregnancy induced the chardi, so there also the persons is having there is vomiting sensation or vomiting and some conditions like especially the hyperacidity because of more intake of the amlasatmaka dravyas, there it produces sometimes the chardi. Here if you take once again the amlasatmaka dravyas, that is viparitarthakari, hetu viparitarthakari. If the hetu is the amlasa, once again we have to treat the same the chardi because which is occur because of the amlarasa, once again you can treat with the amlasatmaka dravyas. That is hetu viparitarthakari, not hetu viparita, hetu viparitarthakari. That is chardi nigrahana mahakashaya. So if you see the drugs like jambu ambra pallava, matulunga, amla badara, dadima, yava, sastika, ushira, mrullaja. So these are the 10 drugs. So here also most of the drugs are having amlarasa and some of the drugs are madurasatmaka dravyas. So they used to do the stambana of the chardi. So that is called as chardi nigrahana. That you can compare with like anti-emetic drugs. Okay. Chardim nigrahanati stambayati iti chardi nigrahanam. The drugs one which controls, the drugs one which suppress the chardi. That is called as chardi nigrahana. Okay. So here also most of the amrasatmaka dravyas are there. Jambu ambra pallava. That is the tender leaves. The tender leaves. If you see the odor of jambu, so which is having a peculiar smell, as it is belongs to the Myrtaceae family. So in that family there is another drug called labanga. So as the labanga leaf and jambu leaves, if you squeeze the leaves, you will get the aromatic the odor. So because of this odor that is present, because of the presence of the volatile oil. So when you take this odor, definitely it suppresses the vomiting center. So by that, they used to suppress the chardi. Okay, that is chardi nigrahana mahakashaya. Then shramahara mahakashaya. So under these three mahakashaya, Acharya Charaka has mentioned dadima is one among. And according to Shushruta, it is considered under parushakadigana. As you all know, parushakadigana, like in Swalpatrifala. So there he used to mention Parushaka. Okay, so one of Parushaka is one of the Amdrasatmaka Dravya. So among them, Shushruta mentioned. Okay, so next we'll move to the synonyms of Dadima. Atipatra, based on the morphology, one of the synonym is having atipatra. If you see the plant, this is actually this is the flowering season, especially in the month of April May, the flowering will occur, and May or in the month of June onwards, the fruiting will start. Okay, so during this, especially in the month of June, if you observe, the whole plant is covered with full of leaves. So sometimes we are unable to see the branches. The small leaves are there, but the whole plant will be covered by leaves. Atipatra. So Bahupatra is one of the synonym of Kumari. Bahupatra, many leaves are present. Here Atipatra means plenty of leaves are present. That is Atipatra. Lohita Pushpaka, based on the flowers, based on the flower of Dadima, one of the synonym is Lohita Pushpaka. Lohita Pushpaka, that is Lohitam Raktavarnam Pushpamashaha. How you have to define Lohita Pushpaka? Lohitam Raktavarnam Pushpamashaha. How the flowers, it looks, how it looks. So it looks like the color of Raktavarna. Lohitam Raktavarnam. It looks like which resembles as like that of blood. Raktavarnam. So the red colored flowers. The flowers of Dadima is red color. Lohitam Raktavarnam Pushpamashaha. Based on the fruit. So most of the synonyms are based on the fruit and even the seeds. Okay. So based on the leaf, Atipatra, and based on the flowers, Lohita Pushpaka. That is also based on the color. Okay. Next we'll move to the based on the fruits. So based on the fruit, Valkala Phala. In some texts they have given Valka Phala. Even in the some Nigantus they have mentioned Valkala Phala. Here Valkala, that is Valkalavrutam Phalamashaha. Valkalavrutam Phalamashaha. That is Punika. How the word, the botanical name they used to derive. The Punika, that is the pericarp. The pericarp is somewhat fleshy nature. That is, they used to say, like, corrosious also they used to say. When the pericarp is fresh, when you break, even if sometimes it is unable to break also. It can fold. That is because of the Valkala. Valkala or Tamphalamashyaha. The fruit is covered by a leathery rind. Leathery. That is because of this leathery nature, we used to call it as corrosious. Okay? Valkala Phala. That is Valkala Urdham Phalamashyaha. Ruttafala. Based, depending upon the shape of the fruit. Depending upon the shape of the fruit, they used to give the synonym as Ruttafalaha. Ruttam Phalamashyaha. The fruits are globose in shape. The fruits of Dadima, which is having ground in shape. Globose. Okay? Ruttam Phalamashyaha. Then Danta Bija. How the seeds, how it looks. So this is based on the resemblance. Danta bijaha, danta sadrushani bijanyashaha, danta sadrushani bijanyashaha. That is the seeds which resembles as like that of teeth. Danta sadrusha. So here they used to say the seeds of Dadima is aprasiddhavastu, whereas danta is prasiddhavastu. They are comparing, they are knowing how the seeds of Dadima, how it looks. So by with the familiar, the name, the familiar one, that is Danta. So everyone knows about how the Dantas, the teeth are present. How the seeds, it looks, definitely the seeds, it looks like the teeth. How the teeth are present, the shape, the size, in that appearance. Danta sadrushani bijanyashaha. The seeds which resembles as like that of teeth. Okay, that is Danta bija. Then another synonym, based on the seeds itself, that is Mani Bija. Mani Bija. Here it is definitely based on the color. Manihi Spatikaha Manikyam Va Tadvad Bijanyashaha. Manihi Spatikaha Manikyam Va Tadvad Bijamashaha. That is, here's to the seeds, it looks like a ruby. That is, in Rasha Shastra, you will come across with this manis. Ratna Mani. So there, it looks like a ruby. That is red colored. The red colored mani. Okay. The mani bija. How the color. So another the synonym based on the seeds. Rakta bija. So mani bija and rakta bija. Almost same meaning. raktavarnani bijanyasyah. So even the flowers also, that is lohitam raktavarnam pushpamasyah raktavarna. Here raktavarnani bijanyasyah, the seeds are also having the color as like that of rakta. Raktavarnani bijanyasyah, how the seeds it looks, how the seeds it looks like raktavarna. Raktavarnani bijanyasyah, the seeds are having like raktavarna, that is raktabijah. So based on the seeds you have three synonyms. One is dantabija, another one is manibija, and another one is raktabija. Okay, so based on the seeds, three synonyms: raktabija, manibija, dantabija. Based on the fruit, like the two synonyms, that is ruttafala, and some acharya says like kuchafala and valkalafala, different synonyms. Okay, next we'll move to the based on the rasa. Rasalakaha, rasalakaha, rasapuranaha, that is the full of, as you all know, that is valkala, that is a pericarp. When you remove the pericarp, the whole fruit is filled with the seeds. That is granatum, it is filled with the seeds. That the whole, the seeds, all the seeds, they used to fill with, the juice, rasa, that is rasalakaha, rasapuranaha. That's why when you cut the fruit, you will get the juice which will spills out. They will come out. That is the word meaning of dadim also. Here rasalaka, it is rasapurnaha. The all the seeds are filled with the rasa. Next, based on the taste, that is swadvamblam. Swadvamblam. In the examinations, they used to ask, so give me any five drugs based on the rasa. So give me any five drugs list which are having the synonyms based on the rasa. Here swadvamblam. Swadvamblam, that is madhuram amblam cha rase. Madhuram amblam cha rase. Dadima, which is having madhura plus ambla rasa. Madhura plus ambla rasa. Madhuramblam rasam che. Then based on the actions, patyakari. Patyakari. What is mean by patyakari? That is hitakaraha. Hitakaraha. There is another, the definition he used to say, patyam pato anapetam yadyachoktam manasaha priyam. So here it is very important, manasaha priyam. So whatever it may be, one which is good for the manas. Patyam pato yadyachoktam manasaha priyam, which is good for the manas. So those drugs are called, used to say, patya. That is hitakaraha, one which is hita to our sharira. It will not cause any the harm to the sharira or harm to the manas. So which is wellness, wholesome for our sharira, that is patyakari, based on the karma. Karakaha krunoti heenasya roganidhi. This is also the synonym based on the karma, that is krunoti heenasti roganidhi. By curing, it will cure many diseases. Krunoti heenasti roganiti. So karakaha, it means it will cure many diseases. It will cure many diseases. Okay. So apart from its the medicinal properties, apart from its the morphology, there are two synonyms, that is sukeshtam and sukavallabha. Sukeshtam and sukavallabha. Suka, that is the Sanskrit name for parrot. Parrot. So it is liked by the parrots. The fruits will be liked by parrots. Sukeshtam, sukavallabaha. It means that it is liked by the parrots. Okay. So this is the synonyms of dadima. So please remember, based on the leaf, atipatra. Based on the leaf, atipatra. And based on the flowers, it is lohita pushpaka. Based on the fruit, valkalafala. Valkalafala. Based on the shape, that is ruttafala, kuchafala. So kuchafala, that is acharyas they have given, it looks like the breast appearance. How the fruit it looks? It looks like a breast appearance. Kuchafalaha, ruttafalaha, valkalafalaha. Based on the fruit. Then based on the seed, like danta bija, mani bija, rakta bija. Based on the seeds. and based on the content of the seed, that is rasalakaha, as the seeds are filled with the juice, and based on the taste, that is swadvamlam, based on the karma patyakari karaka, based on the karma patyakari and the karaka. And apart from these, it is liked by, that is sukeshtam and sukavallabaha, it is liked by the parrots. Okay, next we'll move to the habit. So this is the swarupa. As you all know about, very well about the morphology, if you close your eyes, definitely, so in front of you, so you will get the picture of this plant. Okay, so regarding the morphology, I think no need to necessarily explain in detail, because all of you know about the morphology of this plant. Okay, so this is, as in this picture you are observing, so here you can observe, so there is no main trunk, so you can observe the here the branches 1, 2, 3, 4, there are four branches, and those branches, they used to start from the ground level itself, that is ekamula sanghata jata sharayikshu prabhutayah, ekamula sanghata jata sharayikshu prabhutayah, from the single root many branches they used to arise from the ground level itself. So this is the characteristic feature of shrub or gulma. So definitely you can say, as the main trunk is absent, so definitely you can say this is gulma. But in the text you will get the botanical description as it is a big shrub or a small tree. So sometimes you may get the main trunk, you may get only the main trunk, single main trunk will be present, so in that case you can say it is a tree, that is a small tree. It is a small tree, it is a big shrub or a small tree. So you can write the morphology of Dadima, it is a big shrub or a small tree. So you are observing the picture. Okay, so this is about the leaf, this is about the leaf, how they used to present. So in this picture you can observe, so here what I am showing in the crusher, so this is a thorny branches. The branches are the stem, the terminal part of the stem, or the branches are having a spiny end or a sharp point like structures, that is thorns, because of these characters. Also you can observe in case of Madayantika, Larsonia enormis, so there also the leaves are same, and the branches, that is also bushy appearance, and their branches are also ends with the spiny center, that the terminal branches, they used to like sharp point like structures, that is thorny branches. I have shown in the practical, for practical, during the practical hours also I have shown these characters. Okay, so here you can observe that thorny branches, so because of this only they have included under the Lytheraceae family. Okay, we'll see, this is another picture about the leaf. So here the, so this is a simple leaf, type of leaf is simple, and you can observe the margins of the lamina. Here the margins of the lamina is parallel, so here this is the margin, and here almost the 50 to 60% of the lamina is the parallel, and the 1/3 part of the lamina is gradually tapering. So because of this character you can say like oblong, as the margins of the lamina is parallel, so based on that character we used to say it's the shape of the lamina is oblong. And also the, if you consider this is the width, the width of the lamina is 2 to 3 times, length will be 2 to 3 times more than the width. So depending upon this character you can say like lanceolate, so oblong lanceolate also. And say here the base, so the base here it is also gradually tapering, and here also the apex is also gradually tapering, and it is somewhat, it is broadest at the middle. So depending upon this character you can say this is elliptic also, so oblong lanceolate or oblong elliptic. So this is the shape of the leaf. Okay, so this is another picture. So here you can observe in this picture, so this is one leaf and this is another leaf, so arrangement of the leaf is opposite. Even sometimes we'll get the cluster of the leaf. Okay, so here you can observe the thorny branches. So here there is a presence of thorny branches, and also I will show here in this the axillary region. So from the axillary region and even the terminal part of the branches, they are a sharp point like structure. So because of that, we used to select the thorny branches. Okay. So here also you can observe the thorny branches here, and also you can observe here the thorny branches. Okay. So here there is small the axillary bud will be present. Okay. So this is about leaf. So this is another picture you can observe about the leaf. So leaves are glabrous and shining. Leaves are glabrous and shining. And also we'll see here about the midrib and the lower surface. This is the lower surface. So almost all the upper surface and lower surface almost similar. Usually if you see, most of the plants are having the upper surface is dark or green in color, whereas the lower surface will be somewhat the paleness or dull color will be present. But here it is almost similar, glabrous. Like in case of the Kharpura is also in the same way. Okay. So next we'll move to the another picture. So in this picture you can observe about the inflorescence. This is the flower bud. So this is the flower. So this is about the fruit. Okay. So you can take about the swarupa, habit. That is the external appearance. So it is a glabrous shrub. It is a glabrous, the whole plant. So any of the part, you can take the leaf, you can take the stem, you can take the flowers, or you can take the fruits. Any of the part, the plants is not having the hairs. The whole plant will be absence of the hairs. So that's why they used to say it is a glabrous shrub. It is a glabrous shrub. Or it is a small tree. It is a glabrous shrub or it is a small tree. So which grows about approximately 10 to 15 feet height. Approximately. So not exactly. So it is a glabrous shrub which is or small tree which grows about approximately 10 to 15 feet height. Okay. And we will move to the stem. Stem is gray bark. Stem is gray bark and branches sometimes spinescent. That is thorny branches you can write. So the branches, thorny branches, and even sometimes the axillary region from I have shown in the branches, the axillary branches, the branches are from the axillary region, thorn-like structure will be present. So based on that, you can select the branches are thorny or spinescent. So this is about the habit. Next we'll move to about the leaf. Okay. So leaves are type of leaf is simple. Type of leaf is simple. And the arrangement of leaf, as you observed, it is opposite. Arrangement of leaf is opposite. And the shape, as I have mentioned, that is oblong, as the margins of the lamina is parallel. Both the margins of the lamina is parallel. So depending upon that character, we used to say oblong. And also, so both apex as well as the base, that is gradually tapering. And it is broadest at the middle. So depending upon that character, we used to say it is elliptic. Okay. So oblong or oblong elliptic. Oblong or oblong elliptic. Even the lamina, the length will be more than 2 to 3 times more than the width. So if you consider that character also, it is lanceolate. Oblong, oblong lanceolate or oblong elliptic. So all the characters will be present. So depending upon that, you can write the shape. Next about the apex. So as you all know, the apex is, there is no any projections or any depressions. So depending upon that, we used to say it is an acute. So apex is acute. And the size of the lamina, it is approximately 2.5 to 6 centimeter length. The length of the lamina is 2.5 to 6 centimeter. And the margins of the lamina is entire. I have shown the pictures. The margins of the lamina is entire, and the petiole is short petiole. The petiole will be short. Okay. So this is about the morphology. Okay. Type of leaf is simple. Arrangement is opposite. Shape is oblong or elliptic. Apex is acute. And the size 2.5 to 6 centimeter. And the margin is entire margin. So this is about a leaf. So next we'll move to about the inflorescence. So inflorescence is very peculiar. That is the flowers. Most of the times, the flowers are from the terminal or from the axillary region. So as you are observing, so here most of the flowers, like this is the terminal at the end of the branches, the terminal part of the branches, and in some cases you can observe, I'll show you some pictures where from the axillary region. So usually the flowers are the inflorescence.